The topic which I present you today is the title Convergence or Emerging Diversity. It's about the role of foreign investor on corporate governance in Japan. And this presentation is based on two papers, and I think the commentator is facing some difficulty because there is two papers and they are slightly a technical one. And my strategy of this presentation is based on two papers. I rather try to show a big picture by the economic, so applied economist standard. So as you know, the characteristics of the Japanese corporate system is used to be summarized in this slide by Professor Aoki or famous Sosis Hall's paper of a variety capitalism. And so in the financial side, stable shareholder and main bank system is dominated. And this is corresponding to the system of the board structure or internal governance structure, including boards, which is dominated by corporate insiders. They are promoted within the firm. And this characteristics is also associated to the lifetime employment and a shop floor based training system. However, entering into 1990s, especially after the banking crisis of 1997, this system has been changed quite a lot. And so large scale of changes occurred in three areas. So instead of a main bank system, market-based finance appeared, and the Japanese firm launched a lot of board reform, introducing pay for performance and introducing outside director. And in employment system, contract-based employment, and instead of a seniority wage system, we introduce pay for performance. So then a natural question is how to understand this kind of a change. And in 2007, my co-author Gregory Jackson and myself analyzed changes of corporate governance in Japan, and showing this picture as the one-shot situation of early 2000. And the former Japanese firm rotates in here, which means basically a relation-based system. There is no sign. And So this is the position of the former Japanese firm. And the change looks like this position. So by the way, there is a three dimension. One is the finance, and the other is a board structure. And third one in the employment system, and used to be relation-based, but change occurred. Then the company corporate governance system moved from traditional one toward 0-0-0 area, and this area is a market-based system, market-based finance, outside a dominated board structure, or pay for performance, and explicitly the contract-based employment system. And at the beginning of our estimation, we assumed that the Japanese firm gradually moved towards this direction. But what we found in early middle of 2000 is Japanese firm rotates in this area. So financial system is already market-based, but the board system and organizational architecture is still chiefly a relation-based system. And then we characterized this situation is a hybrid. So corporate governance of Japan is not moving toward US type. So a convergence scenario might not be correct. And the hybrid form is the dominant phenomenon. But of course, there is a counter-argument that this hybrid form may be a transitional phenomenon moving toward US type of the system due to the pressure of the marginalization or financialization. So the other question is, see, if hybrid form is dominated in Japanese corporate governance system in nowadays, but this is a transitional or somehow the sustainable or a kind of a equilibrium which will continue in this stage. So this is a question which we I present you today in this paper or two papers. And understanding for these issues, the key would be the role of institutional investor. And in this point, Professor Aoki suggested a idea that the external monitoring of internal linkage, which means external monitor is an external investor, and whether outsider investor can appropriate, evaluate the linkage between firm's business model and its technological and environment characteristics or not. So this would be a key. So if outside investor could monitor ex ante and ex post and evaluate the appropriate linkage of the corporate employee and business model, then this hybrid form would not be transitional and uniquely evolved. Inspired by this idea, we try to do some empirical work. So as for the role of institutional investor, especially foreign institutional investors, there would be two competing views. And the first view is a positive and the convergence view, which is quite common among financial economists. And in the line of Ferreira Matos and others' paper, they said that institutional investor, foreign institutional investor, can screen growing firms of the emerging market or outside US. And they willingly give a premium on firm with a global standard arrangement, such as outside director and high-powered incentive or information disclosure. And they also had a strong fiduciary duty, so they therefore they exercise their control right. And there are clear evidence that the positive correlation between foreign ownership and firm value. And putting together, they insisted that the foreign shareholder is a driver of a change in the corporate governance in the emerging market. And as a result, the system will converge on the US type. So that's one idea. And the other idea, especially common among the management people, and they are quite skeptical about the convergence story. And what they say is a foreign investor did not have enough knowledge on Japanese firm due to asymmetric information problem. And they preferred a large firm with high liquidity, as well as well-known firms such as Sony or Samsung or Hyundai. And they invested in the firms limited to a company which is incorporated as MSCI index, which is a Morgan Stanley corporate index, around 300 firms. And they prefer the outside director, but in Japan or ASEAN countries, outside director is not necessarily good to all firms. And the stock price went up by the increasing share held by foreign investor, but it would be possible. It's not the result of monitoring, but the result of the just a demand shock of investing this firm. Thus, There is no substantial relation between increasing shareholders of institutional shareholder and corporate performance. So according to this argument, what happened in Japan is still either the governance structure is in a vacuum situation because the main bank system was gone, or the main bank system is originally haven't had enough power and different mechanism is working. So anyway, the institutional investors do not have any strong power. So that's another view, and I try to show which story is right, or what is the much plausible story for understanding this situation. And our view is, we try to show a third story, but both story is at least partly right. So a negative view is at least partly right in the sense that the institutional investor has a strong bias and their preference on corporate governance arrangement is very formal. So you know the ISS, it's a advisory of institutional investor, and investor follows this advice. So what they did is a quite formal preference. However, on the other hand, once share held by foreign institutional investor due to any reason, it certainly plays a significant disciplinary role in governance arrangement, board reform, and the corporate policy and performance. So that the conclusion is external monitors seemingly evaluate internal linkage between business model and economic circumstances in Japan and gradually take a position of an important role of corporate governance. So that's the main story. And what I did is the first step is the, I show the preference of a foreign institutional investor using some estimation. And the second step is whether the increasing foreign institutional investor affects on the stock returns or not. And the answer is yes. And thirdly, what we did in our paper is foreign institutional investor really affect on the corporate governance arrangement, such as the introduction of independent director or corporate policy, such as the payout policy or investment or capital choice. And thirdly, we try to show the relation between level of institutional ownership and corporate performance, carefully considering on reverse causality. And I try to give some perspective in last part in our paper. Okay, and. First, let me show one figure, which is, the, I think, the impressive. And this is the figure of the ownership structure of Tokyo Stock Exchange. And this blue line is the insider. And the insider is defined as the shareholder who's holding stock, or whose incentive for holding stock is not financial performances, but other concerns such as keeping a long-term relationship. And the main composer of this insider is originally in the US or UK sense, manager, ownership, or founder is an insider, but in Japanese context, banks and other corporations is the main composer of insider. And outsider is defined as whose motivation of holding stock is a financial performance. So value maximization. And the main composer used to be individuals. And recently, it's an institutional investor, mainly by foreign institutional investor. And what is impressive is from 70 to middle of 1990s, insider share is over 60%. So across shareholdings, a characteristics of Japanese firm by a lot of advocates is mainly observing this situation. And late 1990s, the situation completely changed. and outsider increased, and now the share held by outsider is over 60%. And the main composer of this increasing outside shareholding is the foreign investors. So that now the role of foreign institutional investor is the main target to be investigated. So this is a detail, and if you have time, please see. And this is the much intuitive one, and Toyota's shareholders, top 10 shareholders list. And formerly, the bank is the largest, but recently a foreign company and some custodian of an institutional investor. Then what I did in our paper is first step is the foreign institutional investor regressed on several factors. And here, what I have to say is the home bias or other concern is the main story. And second step is the relation between rate of return on stock and the foreign institutional ownership. And the bottom line is it has a significant effect. And 5% increase of foreign shareholding associated with a 7% increase in the return. And the third step, I try to show the influence of a foreign institutional investor to corporate governance, and the result is positive. And lastly, I try to show some influence of the governance structure on corporate policy, mainly focusing on investment and payout and financing pattern. And the most important thing is it has a significant effect on investment, especially growing firms, and also a payout for especially for mature firms. And lastly, I estimated the relation between performance and ownership structure carefully considering on the reverse causality. And the conclusion of this estimation is foreign ownership effect on the corporate performance very positively. So altogether, from the empirical stuff, the reality in Japanese firm in the early 2000s is, although negative view is at least right in the sense that they have a strong investment bias under the asymmetric information, and they are portfolio investors so that they less commitment. However, once the share held by foreign institutional investors increased, they certainly influenced governance arrangement, corporate policy, and corporate performances. So tentative result is the foreign shareholder would be playing some external monitoring of internal linkage instead of formal role of a member system. That's all. Thank you.